Okay, we'll start now because already time up now. It was some issue with the technical issue from my side. Okay, the data link control, whatever you discussed earlier. See, normally the physical layer, the information receives in the form of a signal, right? Digital signals. And it provides the synchronization also, physical layer. Once the information is received, the bits are received, the information received in the form of a signal in the physical layer. Those bits, send to the other node, right? Maybe that is where actually the data link layer comes into picture. There, what the data link layer does, it packs, it creates the frames. Okay, there is a packeting actually done. They creates a frame and send to other nodes. This is something like it deals with the, as I said, in the design and procedure for communicating with one node to another node. It is something like a node to node communication, right? This actually deals with the node to node communication in the data link layer. There are two major functions in the data link layer. One is the data link control. Data link control is the function of a data link layer is what I said earlier. It deals with the design and procedure to communicate between the different nodes, between the nodes, adjacent nodes and off the node. Okay, that's what done by the data link control. You have another one is called media access control. We'll discuss media access control in later. The purpose of the media access control is to handle how to share the links. Okay, it actually having a control or maybe authentication how to share the link. Maybe the link should be shared to authorize nodes only, right? That is actually done by the media access control. We'll discuss media access control later. We'll start with the data link control here. Okay, see, data link control, what actually it does. Data link control, what actually the does here? Data link layer needs to be packed bits from frames, right? Bits from frames, so that each frame is distinct from another, right? Before going to this, what I've discussed earlier, the data link control having three major functions. One of the major functions is supposed to be a frame. Okay? Then the second major function is supposed to be error correction as well as detection. Third major function is supposed to be software implemented protocols. Okay, so we'll discuss these things one by one. Let's start with the framing. Now, what is the meaning of framing? Framing is something about you have to that bits you have to send to one node to another node. Now, before sending the whole message, you cannot send it, right? Whole message you cannot send it. You have to break into frames. Right, you can break into different frames. The whole message breaks into a different frames. Then that frames you need to send along, send to one of the other nodes. That is what we normally does. Now, what is the meaning of framing? Is all about the framing is, as I mentioned here, the data link layer needs to pack bits into frames. Okay, so that frame is distinguishable from one another. What happens here for the framing? I'll give you a simple example of our postal system, right? Postal system, what it will do? There are thousands or hundreds of people we are sending the letters from letters, right? Then how it is distinguishable? Normally, the every individual letter is distinguishable by envelope, right? Suppose I am sending some letter, you people are sending some letter. Every individual letters we are distinguished by envelope. I'm using one envelope, you're using envelope, and somebody is using one more envelope. What the envelope will contain? Envelope will contain the address of the source as well as destination also. Who's sending and which address the particular envelope or maybe a letter is supposed to reach and sent by whom. That means the address of the receiver, sender as well as receiver, both we are going to write it on the envelope, right? The envelope is the separator here. See, there are many letters, right? Letter is same concept applied in the framing, applied in the framing source, right? The whole message we are going to smaller message, okay? In the form of a frames. Now, what the frame? How the frame will be separated? Frame will be separated by maybe adding additional bits. Okay, you have to mention end of the frame. Okay, end of the particular frame and at the beginning of the next frame also. How will you distinguish it? We'll call it as a delimiter, right? See, in a postal system, simple postal system, we'll take envelope as a delimiter. Envelope actually makes the difference. It distinguishes. Like this, here also frame you have to distinguish, right? to distinguish the frame, we are using an additional bits, okay, to separate it or maybe distinguish it. That's what we call as a delimiter. Okay. Now, see the simple act of inserting letter. Okay, the simple act of inserting a letter into envelope separates one piece of information from another. Okay, the envelope serves as a delimiter when it comes to postal system. But when it comes to actual our digital communication, what happens? Instead of envelope, we are using either additional bits will be added, or maybe special characters can be added. Okay, so that it distinguishes one frame to another frame, one frame to another frame. Okay, now. This data link, we'll discuss here. Actually, the thing is, frame consists of the framing can be divided into again two categories. One is the fixed frame, the size of the frame I'm talking about. Okay, one is the fixed frame size. Fixed frame size, what happens here? Whatever the frame you're going to send it, it is going to be fixed one, right? There is no need to mention the boundaries here, no need to mention the boundaries here because it is a fixed size. You know that this frame can carry only this much of its size of it. That's it. Okay. And one of an example for the fixed size framing is ATM network. Okay. ATM network, which is used in ATM wireless network, we'll call it as WAN. ATM WAN. ATM is what? Asynchronous network, right? ATM network. It is asynchronous mode network, right? So, in ATM, WAN, this fixed size framing normally we are going to use it. No need to mention the boundaries there. Then normally, most of other applications, we are not going for a variable. Okay, especially in a local area network, you cannot go with fixed size. You have to go with the variable size. Variable size framing, we call it as. In a variable size framing, what happens? Every frame is having a different size. You cannot define the fixed size for frame here. Then how do you differentiate? How do you differentiate individual frames here? That means there should be you need to add a delimiter, right? You need to add a delimiter because the sizes are totally different, right? So in a variable size frame, there are two types of technique you can use to separate the frames here. One of the technique normally used, we call it a character oriented approach. Okay. See, in a variable size framing, there are two approaches. One is a character oriented approach. In a character oriented approach, normally what we're going to do, we are going to insert. See, what we are going to do, you need to define, okay, define the end of the frame, okay, and beginning of the next frame. These two things you need to define it, right? How do you define it? The first approach which I'm talking about is a character-oriented approach. Character-oriented approach. In a character-oriented approach, what we will do? We are going to send a header, right? What are the things header normally contains? Header will normally contain the actual message you need to send it, the first one. Then you need to send a flag, right? What is a flag? Flag is something about it indicates that the end of the particular frame, okay, or maybe a beginning of the next frame, right? It contains, the bit should be added beginning of the frame and end of the frame also. That means the beginning of the frame, it indicates that beginning of the new frame. End of the frame, it indicates that end of the current frame. Okay, that's what we call the flag, right? The header will contain the actual data you're supposed to send it along with the flag bit, which says that, which separates the different frames. And the third one, which contains other bit, we'll call it as error detection and correction bit. That will be added. That's what we call as a trailer, right? It contains a trailer also. That means error detection and correction bits will be added to that, right? So these are the things normally header will contain. See, when it comes to character-oriented approach, what happens here? You're actually adding 8-bit character, okay? 8-bit character you're supposed to be added here. So this is something like, the character may be decoded. Maybe you can take it from the ASCII value, the ASCII characters. You know the ASCII characters, right? So you take it from those characters and you're going to insert it. You're going to insert it in the character-based approaches here, right? And this is how the frame in the character-based, character-oriented approach. This is how, the header will contain, okay? See, what you're going to do, you're going to add a flag here. okay, which indicates that beginning of the frame. Beginning of the frame, then you have an actual data you are going to have it, and this is what the variable number of characters that you are going to add it. What actually does this variable number of characters? It distinguishes the different frames. Distinguishes the different frames. This whatever the variable number of characters you are going to mention is a character from the ASCII, right? ASCII is supposed to be what? 8-bit. 8-bit is supposed to be we are going to character. One character consists of 8-bit, right? So that's what we are going to insert it here. Then you have a trailer, of course, error detection and correction. Trailer you are going to have it. Trailer is nothing but error detection and correction. Then you have another flag. This flag indicates that end of the frame. The flag in the beginning, it indicates that start of the new frame. And flag in the end, you can see the end of the current frame. This is what you are going to define it in the character oriented approach. See, in this case, what happens, we have the only one character you're going to insert it. In the sense, imagine we are going to send only a text message, then this approach will be ideal. Okay, whatever the character going to mention is a special character, the character which is not there in the text what you're going to send, that you're going to insert it. Okay, this particular case is an ideal case where you're sending a text. Okay, in that text, the character which is not there in the particular text, you are going to insert as a flag here. Got it now? The character which is not there in the text you are supposed to set it, right? Not there in the particular text, that you need to identify those character. Only that character will be inserted here as a flag here. Whenever it arises, that particular character, okay, the receiver thinks that there is an end of flag or maybe beginning of the flag or end of the flag. It automatically identifies. Right, there's a special character, right? So, but what happens nowadays? Most of the time, we are using the Unicode system, right? Unicode system. This in a Unicode system, normally what we do, what is supposed to be, is a 16-bit or 32-bits in Unicode. So, it is sending an 8-bit character is no more is available now. Since we are using most of the time, we are using Unicode now, right? Unicode is basically a 16-bit or 32-bit. So, we normally go for a Unicode now, right? So this is about the frame character oriented. Here is one case. Let us take another scenario. See, inserting what a character here we call is a bit stuffing, right? Maybe we are inserting, that means we are separating it. Now what happens, we'll discuss what is the byte stuffing as well as unstuffing is. Let us imagine you are sending instead of text messages, we are sending some I can say videos or audios, multimedia files here too. So you are going to send it. Video file, video files or audio file, whatever you're going to send it. Now what happens, whatever the character you're going to insert it, right? That may be chances that same character may be exist in the data also. Data also may contain the same character. Then you may not have a special, you will not be able to get a special character, right? Whatever you are going to send it as a delimiter, okay, same character may be there in the data format, data also. Then how will you do it? What happens in this particular scenario, whenever this particular character arises, the receiver thinks that there is an end of a frame, but actually will not. Actually, the data will not end, right? The particular frame will not end, right? See, that means the data which is, the text which is contained in the data, okay, and the character which is added, both are similar here. Both are same. Whenever the particular data, the particular character arises, the receiver thinks that there's an end of a frame. But in reality, there is no end of a frame. There is continuation of the frame. Continuation of the frame. Then how do you distinguish that? The distinguishable, that particular distinguishable, the particular process, normally call it as the byte stuffing. Okay. In this byte stuffing, what you're going to do, we are going to add some kind of a characters. Okay. That's what normally called as an escape. Okay. We are going to, whenever that, character arises, see, you are mentioned as a flag, right? Right? And it's the same flag it arises, okay? It compares with the data. And even data also contains the same kind of character. Whenever it is become same, what actually does, it byte stuffing will be done. Byte stuffing is something about insert. It insert the special characters, maybe a series of characters, okay? That's what normally call it an escape, right? Escape. This escape is one of the things which you are going to escape character here, right? See, whenever this escape arises, what actually does in the receiving end, it removes that escape character. Okay, it removes the escape characters. Whatever the data which is available in the next one, it thinks that continuation of it. It thinks that continuation of it. Okay, that is the purpose of byte stuffing. In earlier case, suppose if you are not employed, if you are not used byte stuffing, normally what happens whenever flag which is mentioned earlier, right? The same character arises in the data also. The data also contains the same character. Then thinks that it is a separate frame. Okay, it ends. But here what happens? In reality is not same, right? In reality, what happens? That is not the end of frame. That is a continuation of the same frame actually. Now to understand by the same frame, we actually go for byte stuffing. In byte stuffing, what actually do? Whenever it thinks that the same character flag, whatever you are going to add flag as well as the data which is there in the data, both are same, then it insert an escape. It insert a special character which is actually something called as an escape. Now whenever escape identified by the receiver, okay, identify the receiver, it removes escape. Okay, then understand that it is not end of frame, it is a continuation of the frame. That's what we'll call it as a byte stuff. Okay, let us imagine one more scenario where you have a series of the data will contain the series of same flag. Okay, series of the same flag. For example, the flag you're going to add, right? Same character, the data will contain many number of times same characters in the data. Data will contain many number of same character. You can see in this particular case, we have a multiple of escape, right? We are adding multiple escape here, multiple escape, right? What happens whenever the same character is repeated in the data, okay? Repeated in the data, then whenever the escape arises, okay, then it insert one more escape here. The reason is it is not an end of frame. It is not an end of frame. That's a continuation of the frame there, right? It insert one more delimiter. It is not a delimiter actually. It inserting one more escape here. One more escape. Okay. Whenever is there are two escape continuously, it appears thinks that data is the frame is not end. Frame is not end. Okay. Still the frame is continuous. Okay, you can see this, there are two escape here. If you extra two bytes are added, you can see frame receive which contains a flag header, of course as usual this escape will contain and there is a flag will be there. Okay, flag will be there. Then you have started with this escape will remain, and of course this contains the escape also. This it inserting one more escape here, right? Then what you supposed to do when it is received at the receiver end, it should have to unstuff it. How do you unstuff it? You can see this, there is an escape, there is a flag here, right? Whenever it receives as a flag, it will remain as a flag in this particular data format, right? In the data remains this particular flag, and here is a continuous two escape, right? Continuous two escape. Out of that, one escape is removed and only one escape will keep it in this particular data here. This is what the data you are going to send it to the upper layer. This is what normally called it as byte stuffing and unstuffing. Byte stuffing and unstuffing. Okay. Now, byte stuffing is a process of adding one extra byte. Byte stuffing is the process of adding one extra byte whenever there is a flag or escape character in the text. Okay. Then the second one, the first one is a character oriented, is actually practically is a very difficult one, because most of the time you are not sending only a text message. Most of the time you are sending the along with the text message, we are sending the images also, we are sending the videos also, audios also, many things you are going to send it. That is why character oriented approach in reality may not be ideal one. Okay, may not be ideal one. So that is why we have one more approach. We call it a bit oriented approach. In a bit oriented approach, what happens, instead of inserting the character, actually you are going to insert the bits here. Instead of characters, we are going to insert the bits here. In this particular example, you can see this is what the normal standard flag we are going to normally are going to insert it to distinguish between the different frames. different frames. Okay. See, in this particular frame, it contains, this is a frag. Whenever it arises, this particular bit pattern, it indicates that beginning of the frame. Okay. Of course, this you have a header, this actual information will contain. Then this is spot. Whenever this information which contains here, okay, of course it contains a trailer. Trailer is nothing but error detection and correction codes. You have it. This is an end of a flag. Okay, this is a scenario similar to earlier one. What happens? The data also contains the same flag. Whenever the data also contains the same flag, then the receiver should have to understand. Should have to understand that it is not an end of frame, it is a continuation of the frame, right? Same scenario applies here also. Suppose whatever you're going to send the data frame here, okay? This data frame, suppose the data frame also contains the same flag bit pattern, right? That means that it is not an end of frame actually. It is a continuation of the particular frame. Then how do you distinguish it? How do you distinguish it is a very important one here. You can see variable number of bits will be added. Okay, data from the upper layer which you have received, right? And when it's received, you actually are going to add this one here. You can see 0, okay, 5 ones you are going to add it, right? We'll discuss this in the next slide. You can able to understand. See, bit here also we are using a bit stuffing here. Bit stuffing, what you're going to do is the process of adding adding one extra 0 whenever 5 consecutive ones follow 0 in the data, so that the receiver does not mistake the pattern 0110, that is 51, as for a flag. Okay, flag, this is whatever you mentioned here, this is actually a flag, right? But data also may contains the same pattern. If the data also say contains the same pattern, what actually is, suppose if you're not applied the bit stuffing, the receiver understands that there is an end of a frame, right? But actually it's not end of the frame, it's a continuation of frame, because data bit whatever it contains similar to the flag, similar to flag, but it is not exactly a flag, right? It is a continuation of the same pattern. Here what you are going to do, again you are going to apply bit pattern, that is bit stuffing here, right? Bit stuffing, what actually does, whenever it arises, okay, it compares with the flag. When it compares with the flag, it thinks that it is similar to that flag. Then normally what it does, encounters continuous 5 ones, it adds 0. You can see byte stuffing is a process of adding one extra zero whenever 5 consecutive ones follow a 0 in the data. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Whenever 5 consecutive ones are following 0, right, data, so that the receiver does not mistake a pattern of 0, 5, 1 as 0 for a flag, right? This is how what we call as a bit stuffing. Now let us take one more, the scenario similar to earlier one. What you discussed is similar to earlier one. This is what the data from the upper layer. In this particular data from the upper layer, you can see there are 3 zeros. Okay, you have how many? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Just 2 minutes. Just 2 minutes, guys. Okay, sorry. Sorry for interruption in between. So let us take one of the same scenario here. In this particular scenario, what happens? You are receiving actually data from the upper layer. Is this is what the data you have received. You can see 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay. 1, there are 6 ones here, then followed by 0 again, right? Then again, you can see 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is actually matching to a flag, is similar to a flag, right? When it is encounter similar to a flag, what happens? Normal case, what happens? The receiver thinks that there is an end of frame. The flag, what you're going to send it here, this value also similar. So it thinks that there is an end of frame, but practically will not. How do you differentiate it? With the help of a bit stuffing. Here actually you are going to stuff here. We are going to done a bit stuff here. What are we going to do? You can see zero. Okay. Then what is that? Followed by five zeros here, five ones here, consecutive ones. One, 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 one. There are five consecutive ones here, right? Whenever five consecutive ones arises, it inserts next zero, zero here. Bit zero will be inserted. Okay. The purpose of inserting zero is to make you know, like the receiver should have to understand that it is not an end of a frame, it is a continuation of frame. Okay, it is not an end of frame, it's a continuation of frame. Why it is still will be understand, you know, like it thinks like that, because the value of this particular value is changed here now, right? Whenever this value of this particular is changed, then receiver, they, you know, it will not misinterpret at all. The value is totally changed because you inserted one after five consecutive ones here. That means the value is changed here. Whenever this value is changed, there is no question of misinterpretation, right? So then again, it continues like that. So of course, you have a trainer, this error and detection code you are going to add it. Of course, it's an end of flag you will have it. This flag again, this flag, both are indicated. This is actually beginning of the frame. This flag indicates end of the frame, right? Then let us take one more scenario, like earlier scenarios. Suppose you have a, you know, long bit pattern you have in the frame, then it is having continuous. Long patterns you have it. It may contains two times same flag. It may come, you know, similar to a flag. Imagine you have maybe a two consecutive long pattern which may contain similar to a frame. Two times you have it. Then what will you do? Again, there you have to do it bit by, you know, the bit stuffing here. You can see this case, this may contain, there is a continuous, there are two times of flag here, similar to a flag. Okay. Then what you are going to do? Zero will be stuffed here, right? Then one zero will be stuffed. Of course, this is what the pattern you are going to receive it here. This is what the pattern received by the receiver. Okay. The value is changed. Now you need to unstuff it. At the receiving end, what you supposed to do, you need to unstuff it. Unstuff it in the sense, whatever the bit you are going to you have added to differentiate, right? Or maybe to make sure that it is not the end of a frame, continuous of frame, right? That bit you need to remove it. That removing process, normally call it as unstuffing. Whatever zero you have added, right? We have removed it here. It's similar to this. Whatever data is sent from the upper layer, we are going to receive it here. That is where the unstuffing is all about, unstuffing process. Right, zero you have added here. Here you added zero, and you have added zero also. That means in this case, what happens? There's a this data frame will contains two times of similar value of flag here. Got it? This data frame actually contains two times of similar value of a flag. That is why we added two zeros here. You can see after consecutive five ones added zero here. After consecutive five ones added zero here. It makes sure that there's a continuation of frame. Now this is what we have received here in the receiver end. Receiver end is received. Now what the receiver supposed to do? It should have to unstuff it. Unstuff it in the sense, whatever an extra bit you have added, that you need to remove it. That means zero we have added in this particular place, right? This zero should have to remove it here, right? Zero should have to remove it here, and it should have to come up with the original frame here. This is what the original frame which the receiver has converted, right? Unstuffing is done in the receiver end. Unstuffing is done here. This is what normally call it as. Okay. Normally call it as bit stuffing and unstuffing. Right. Now, this flow and error control, what do we do? I'll just start with a new session. Right. Flow and error control, I'll start with a new session. I'll just disconnect it. I'll request all the participants to reconnect it now. Okay. Reconnect it. I'll just disconnect it now. Please reconnect it for the flow and error control. I'll send an email right now.